And today, what do we have, folks? A grubby, made in the USA, not very well adjusted Telecaster. I guess the first thing to do would be to plug it in and see what it does.
Well, you're here with me, folks. This is how they land. That's just lack of use. We're missing our knobule here. Unfortunately, I do not have one. So we'll just have to cut our hands open. All right. What could go wrong next? I've already eyeballed the neck, and it seems unbelievably straight. In fact, too straight, as in backbowed, right? So, let's find the truss rod wrench and release things. This is usually where shit goes off the tracks, because you need that extra long wrench. So every time I look at one of those, and I see that the plug has all been ratted. See, this is not a good sign because the truss rod seems to be loose. I don't know, that's actually tightening. Straighten out, Dave. Yeah. Okay, does it push two ways? Because it's just floating around in there like nothing. I don't know, it's catching the other way. Is it going to blow the walnut plug out the other side? I don't know. Let's see what happens. Alright, like what could go wrong? Well, that actually worked like a charm. So we're in luck. Truss rod works. So what I'll do with this, just because it's so messed up and out of whack, take everything off, take the strings off, not everything off, take the strings off. Put the neck in a perfectly straight condition with nothing on it, clean it up, and set it up.
So if you take all the bridge saddles and spin them on their sides, you can get this rag in there, get all that shit out of there without having to take it all apart. A little compressed air is going to help too.
Well, it's definitely been played. And as I said, I put the straight edge on it, and it's this neck is not in really good shape right now. So if I just sort of put the truss rod, I know I'm down here, right? If I just sort of put the truss rod in the center position, right? You know, it's not tight. There, it's just starting to tension. Then it goes sloppy. And then we start to tension the other direction. So what you'd really hope for right now, when that's sort of in the middle, maybe with a little bit of tension in the tightening zone, is you really want this piece of wood to be straight right now with no strings on it. But what's happening to me is it's still got a back bow. So I am going to make an executive decision. It had 9s on it. I'm going to put 10 to 46s on it. Just give it a little pull because it's just, I don't think it's going to play right. Well, it has strings. And she's tuned to bitch. So let's see what the truss rod did. Actually, I correct myself. Let's see what the truss rod didn't do. Just seems to be sort of all over the place, wiggly. So right now, the neck is too straight. And I have fret buzz for 100 years. So we're pretty sure I had it loosened. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna try and use, there, it's right loosened off now. Hopefully it's going to tension a little bit in the other direction. Come on, you can do it. Just keep spinning around in there, boys. Spinning and spinning. Okay, so we're starting to tension in the direction we'd like the neck to go. And I think we are achieving success. Yeah, I'll roll with that. The thing is, guitars that never ever get adjusted or set up or looked at, the truss rod, you know, really requires incremental adjustment over time. And also with the seasons.
You know, if you don't have any seasons,
obviously nothing's going to change. But here we got hot, cold, winter, humid, not humid. And the dynamics of the machine change over time. So most of the stuff I get, folks, when you see the necks are all bent and warped and things aren't working right, it's because they have never probably ever been adjusted and have been left for way too long like that. It's not a good thing. So I think I got that covered. Let's do some string height. Okay, so I'm going for the James Burton setup, which is 4/64 at the 17th fret. And we're very close. The A string, when it came to me, was just totally ridiculously too high. So we'll eyeball these all in to where they should go, and then we'll retune it and recheck it all again. Just like the big boys. I like that. That's, geez. Well, we're looking pretty good. We're looking really good, folks. Click on the Peterson. Plug her in. Little intonation for starvation. Now, so I guess some pickup height, right? Just want to double check the string heights again before I get into that, because one will affect the other. Yeah, I'm totally rocking with that. Turn off the spinning Peterson and see what's going on with these guys. That one's too close. That one's too far away. I hope everybody's doing great. Just want to once again thank everyone for hanging out with me, especially my patrons. Facebook group's coming along. Got a few dickheads, but that goes with life. What else? Oh, Penny Black CDs. Thank you, everyone. Please jump in and get one. I can live with that. Okay. That's it. Thank you so much. Oh, yeah, that's Tellylicious. Better quit screwing with it, I'll break a string. Thanks for hanging out, folks. We'll see you next time. Cheers.